Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. My name is Brent and in today's video we're going to go over how to open up your very own Merrill Edge account here in 2021 and get up to $1,000 credited to your account for opening and funding your account over on Merrill Edge. So with that said, if you are brand new to the channel, have not yet subscribed, go down below, hit the red button to subscribe, make it great, hit the bell to be notified every time we release a brand new video, and of course, give this video a thumbs up, make it blue. Here on the channel, we cover making money, saving money, and investing money, and here, we're going to be making up to $1,000 by opening up an account, and we'll also be able to invest our capital here on the Merrill Edge platform. If you guys aren't or haven't checked out my website, Investing on the Go, definitely check it out or follow me on Instagram or Facebook at Brent Matters Investing. So let's go ahead and get into the video. Okay, if you are not a member of Merrill already, you just have to either head over to Merrill.com or just type into Google Merrill and, you know, Merrill Bank of America, and you'll come right here to this website if you are not a member. Now, if you're not a member, that's completely fine. We're going to go over the process whether you are not a member or you are a member. So here in this case, up in the top right corner, you would select open up an account. Now, if you are a member, you have two different ways of opening up an account. So here, for example, I am logged into my dashboard where I can see my accounts here. I have an IRA, Roth IRA, an individual account, a cash managed account, taxable. And we can do this two ways here when you're signed on. You can select open an account in the top right corner, or you also have the option down in the bottom. If you scroll down, you'll be able to select open an account. Now, once you've selected those options, you'll have the same format whether you are an existing member or haven't used Merrill in the past. So here, we're just going to go ahead and decide what type of account we're going to be opening. And in this case, we want Merrill to show all of our available options. So here I'm selecting show me all the accounts. Now Merrill Edge offers a ton of different platforms. You know, the most common ones are up on the screen now, from the individual brokerage account, that's going to be your taxable account, to a Roth IRA, traditional IRA. Those are your retirement accounts. You have a rollover. So if you have a 401k, Roth 401k, Roth 401b, that's going to be a rollover style. You have your next generation 529 plans for, you know, your kids, joint brokerage accounts for, you know, married couples, custodian brokerage. This is one that I'm looking on opening up on behalf of my son, who's now six, who has a couple hundred dollars that he wants to start investing and beginning earning some dividends. So, you know, I'll be opening up probably a custodial account under my name for him. And then we have the SEP IRA, which is for businesses. So it's a retirement account for businesses, but you also have other options here from general retirement, education, and small business. So in this case, we are opening up an individual brokerage account, which we can select open now. Now, this is where you're going to be able to get up to $1,000 of credit to your account by opening up an account. So here on this page, what you want to make sure you do is that you do have an offer code. You're going to have the select, do you have an offer code? And then you're going to be prompted to enter an offer code. Here, as of June 2021, when I'm recording this video, if you were to type in there a 1000 ME, you know, 1000 Merrill Edge, and apply the code, you'll be able to be credited up to $1,000 of cash, you know, applied to your account. Now, here we can select the terms. So here, when you are starting this account up, you must fund your account with at least $20,000 of new net assets within the first 45 days of opening your account. So $20,000 can be quite a bit for a lot of individuals. So this offer isn't for everyone, but it definitely has some really good perks down below. So if you open up your account with anywhere from $20,000 to $49,999, you can get $100, $50,000. To $99,999, that's $250. And if you open it up with $100,000 to $199,000, that's cash reward of $500. And if you open it up with $200,000 or more, that's $1,000 right there credited to your account. And that's after 180 days, 6 months. So if you leave it in there or 6 months. So it's definitely a long-term plan in order to get that capital. But if you are planning on sticking with more traditional broker outside of your Robinhood, outside of your M1 Finance, Webull, then Merrill Edge is a great platform when comparing it to the more traditional brokerages such as Schwab, Fidelity, and so on. So it's definitely up there and available. Now, once you've kind of read over the offer and you've kind of made your decision as far as how you want to fund it, go ahead and begin your application. Now, here you can see that we're going to be supplying personal information, employment and financial information, going over account deals, reviewing everything before we sign, and then we submit our application in order to get approved. And here we can see that our offer is being applied for that $1,000 cash offer. So you just kind of go over the primary applicant and fill out the personal information and so on. Next, after you've gone to the next page, you're going to go ahead and enter in your employment and financial information. You know, what's your employment status, your company name, category, where you live, and, you know, what's your current net of assets? You know, what are you comfortable with? How much do you get money? There's all sorts of questions. You just kind of go through there. And then once you've done that, here you have the options of opening up a few different account details. Do you want to be on margin? In my case, I'm not too interested in having a margin account just because that comes with a ton of other, you know, responsibilities and risks. I think if the market was in a less, you know, inflated stage, I may be more comfortable with a margin. But at this moment, I just chose not to select a margin account. I didn't need their debit card and I didn't need any sort of check writing. So in my case, I didn't select anything. I just went down below and hit continue. Here, you're going to go ahead and review all your information before you submit your application. So this goes over all your personal information once again, social security number, your marital status, financial data. And then once you have done that, you're going to go ahead and hit continue once again. It's going to show you some of the account features that you either signed up for or did not sign up for. In this case, we can see that we selected no across the board because we don't need margin, a debit card, or check writing offered to us. We can still see that our offer is being applied here of a $1,000 cash offer. And we go ahead and continue to terms and conditions. Now, after you have read your communication disclosure, selected the boxes, and read over your client relations summary, best interest statements, and then you hit continue, here you're just going to have to basically make sure that the four statements are true. You know, the primary thing here is that you are a U.S. citizen or U.S. person, including a U.S. resident alien with a green card. I've seen a couple individuals out there who have tried to open up accounts with Merrill Edge that have left me comments saying that they have not been able to open up an account. And essentially, you do have to be a U.S. citizen or a U.S. person with a U.S. resident alien card. So that's just something I see a lot of individuals kind of miss. So I just want to make sure that we check that here in the video checkbox there, making sure that this is all correct, and hit continue. Here, you're just going through some additional terms and conditions. Make sure you read through all of that. If you want to look through any of the agreements, definitely recommend it, and you'll go ahead and hit continue once again. Now, if everything goes well, your application will be approved on the spot. Here, I waited just a few minutes, and my application was approved for my cash management account. That's my taxable individual account. Here we can see the details of my offer. So I've been enrolled in the $1,000 cash offer. I have to fund my account within the first 45 days of the account being open, and I have to leave my money in the account for at least 180 days, as we've covered, is roughly 6 months. So here we are in June, opening up our account. We have to leave this cash in the account up until December of 2021 in order for us to get our cash. So within 45 days, I just have to fund it. Now you have a couple different options here, from transferring cash, ACH transfer, wire transfer. Basically, you know, you have a ton of options. So if we click here to fund our account, we'll be able to transfer cash from a linked account. You know, so if you have another taxable account, a joint account, or external account, you'll just go ahead and select transfer cash from, and then you'll enter how much you are wanting to transfer into your account. Now you can also link up other accounts in order to transfer from the account, make it reoccurring, similar to what other platforms have, where you can just kind of set up a plan of depositing every single week, every single month, or a one-time upfront deposit, and then have that invested for the remainder of the year. Then you'll go ahead and select next, and you'll review and submit your information here. You'll basically be see where you're bringing your cash from, where what account you're bringing it to, your transfer amount, and the transfer date that you're initiating the transfer, and just making sure that that is all correct, and you will go ahead and submit your information. So that is basically it as far as opening up your own Merrill Edge account. Now, this platform is more traditional, so they're going to be offering a ton of more options versus, you know, M1 Finance, Robinhood, Webull. That's one of the main reasons I decided to kind of go back to the traditional route from where we had done in the past. So on the Merrill Edge platform, you actually have a ton of tools right on your dashboard. Once you do sign in, you'll be able to access all your accounts quick and easy, make trades, research, ton of information. I've had other videos in the past, but I can definitely make other videos on what Merrill Edge has to offer as far as their research platform. You can get some guidance and assistance in kind of planning out your retirement. You usually have during the day a chat feature, so if you ever want to speak with somebody live, you can go down below. They usually have a little chat bubble where you just kind of pop in your name and you can start talking with somebody. You can get somebody on the phone very quickly. You know, I've been working on transferring my M1 Finance account out of M1 Finance, so I was able to kind of speak with somebody on a chat and then have somebody call me directly, get walkthrough as far as what I needed to request and how to do it. And it was very quick and easy as far as getting that process completed. So hopefully this video was helpful to you guys, especially if you guys are available to get up to that $1,000 of credit. And let me know down in the comment section below, what broker are you currently with? Are you looking to move to a more traditional broker, or are you pretty comfortable with using Robinhood or Webull or such? So that is basically it for this video. If you have any comments or questions, drop them in the comment section down below. If you are brand new to my channel, have not yet subscribed, go down below, hit the red button to subscribe, make it great, hit the bell to be notified every time we release a brand new video. And of course, if you haven't checked or followed me on Facebook or Instagram, definitely check me out at Brent Matters Investing. And that is it. Thank you all for tuning in. I will see you guys next time. Have a great day. Bye.